Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel Learn English with Yasvi. So today I'm going to tell you reported speech, direct and indirect speech. So now talking about direct or quoted speech. Direct or quoted speech is a sentence or several sentences that report speech or thought in the original form as phrased by the original speaker. It is used enclosed in the quotation marks. Indirect or reported speech. So the verb tense necessarily change in the reported speech. This is because when we report speech, we are talking about something that was said in the past. If the reporting verb in the direct speech statement is in the present tense or future tense, then it remains same in the indirect speech too, i.e. that means that no change in tense. For example, my friend say he is very handsome. So what you will just write in the answer to this question? So you write that my friend say that. So we are going to add that over here. He is very handsome, right? And you will remove the apostrophes, right? So now talking about the rules applied on the tenses, simple present will be converted into simple past, present continuous to past continuous, present perfect to past perfect, present perfect continuous to past perfect continuous, simple past to past perfect continuous to present perfect continuous to past perfect continuous, right? And past perfect continuous, there will be no change. And past perfect also, there will be no change. So now talking about the SON formula. First person subject, second person object, third person no change. So subject in that S, object O-N from no change N. So that's how the SON formula has become. Now telling you the example of the first person subject, that is, if I say, he said to her, I like coffee, and I like coffee is in apostrophe marks, and he said to her, after that there is comma, right? Now how will you change this sentence? So he told her that he liked coffee, and comma will be just removed, and even the apostrophes will be removed. Moving to the second person object, that is, if I say to you like he said to her, you look happy. So her, after her, there will be comma, and you look happy will be in apostrophes. So what will you write now? So you will write like, he told her that she looked happy. We will remove over here the commas and the apostrophes. Moving to the third person where there no change is, but we need to remove the commas and the apostrophe in the third person, right? He said to him, she has already left. So she has already left is in the apostrophe, and you will remove the apostrophe, and you will write that he told him, said, it will become into told. So he told him that she had already left. Okay. Now talking about change in adverb of time and place, this will become that today, that will become that day, then these will become those, now will become then, here, there, tomorrow, the following, next day, yesterday, the previous day, the day before, and tonight, that will become into that night, right? Now talking about change of adverbs, I will clarify you this change of adverb by giving you two examples. So I will just dictate the question plus answer. Listen to them carefully to just understand the concept of changes of adverb. Okay, so he said, comma, now it will start by the apostrophes. I shall discuss this matter next week, apostrophe close this, and next is underlined. So now the underlined word will change. He said that he would discuss that matter the following week. Moving to the next example question. She said, comma, apostrophe started, we shifted to this house 2 weeks ago. This and ago are underlined, and underlined verb will change, right? So she said that they had shifted to that house 2 weeks before. So now let's move to other topic. Okay, so now let's start interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences, a question is changed into a statement in a direct yes, no question. Reporting verb is changed into ask, inquire, and if whether is used. Let me give you example to understand it more clearly. Example question 1. She said, comma, apostrophe, are you writing a poem? Apostrophe, close, and question mark. She asked me whether I was writing a poem. Question mark. Then, moving to the next example question, I said to him, comma, apostrophe, do you know when she will go home? Question marks and apostrophe, close. I asked him if he knew when she would go home? Question mark. So now moving to the imperative sentences. An imperative sentence, reporting verb is changed into ask, advice, request. The ends remain the same and the verb is put into the infinity too. I said, comma, in the apostrophe, take your seat, apostrophe, close. So the example answer will be, I asked him to take his seat, right? So this will be the answer. So now moving to the last topic of today, that is exclamatory sentence. In exclamatory sentence, reporting verb is changed into exclaim with joy, sorrow, anger, surprise, etc. that is used. For example, question, he said, comma, in the apostrophe, how beautiful a place, exclamatory mark, and apostrophe close. So he exclaimed with joy that it was a very beautiful place.